Hi, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
You're looking like a class. All other kind of good morning, Bolre. Good morning.
Good morning.
Happy morning to all of you in Indore. My name is Dr. Alok Pandit, and I'm the director of CMO Asia, and also a part of the team that's conducted this great program. I'm actually proud of that and giving it a tag of great before we even started. Because looking at all of you guys here, I'm sure it's going to live up to its tag. So Indore, the cleanest city in India. Felt my first time here, so it was actually very clean when I just walked into the airport. Two bells, but all smiling people, ready to help. Small shops inside the airport, but once you're outside, you feel the heat. Very hot. And even the aircon in the car doesn't help you much because the car is already heated up before even it leaves the destination. So just as if getting into a preheated oven and then traveling from airport into the city. Open roads, lots of construction happening. The metro, I think, is the buzzword here. I also saw the metro here, which is coming up right outside the hotel. Spent some time being a foodie at the food joints in the night, enjoying some really different tastes of omelets, pizzas, little bit of chaat, and faluda to end the evening with before calling it a night. And in the morning, all your smiling faces, people coming on time, some are yet to join. But before we start off, can we applaud for all of you guys here? The sound of applause will depict the sound of energy at your end. So remember that if you applaud harder, energy is much more bigger. If you applaud less, it will be less. The most important thing, remember, keep smiling. Keep smiling, keep smiling, and keep smiling. Because that helps, and that is the difference between a human and obviously a zombie. I'm sure you all want to be called as humans and not zombies. It's a good Guruvar here. So Sai Baba ka din hai. And we will start this program today with a tribute to a Mother India. 75 years that we have, 76 currently now going on, of independence that we say. Freedom as we call it, how much free we are, is open to debate on another day. But we still are the largest democracy here on the earth. So can we all stand up as we play the national anthem of the Republic of India? Thank you so much. Take your seats. Before we start, let me hear from you guys what your expectations are for the next couple of hours. I'm sure you would have come to this program investing your time, your energy, and staying away from your workplace with something in mind. Let me hear what your expectations are, what you want to take away, what are you feeling in terms of. Everyone has got this inner feeling, next is what? Fir kya? And I have some views here. Let me make this interactive. Let everyone contribute here. Let's ensure that this whole room of around 60 odd individuals come together as a common group and just talk. Can I have some volunteers? Great. Introduce yourself to the group.
So, good morning, everybody. Myself, Piyush Agrawal. What my expectations from the event today is to find out who the leaders are in Madhya Pradesh and what are they doing in their respective fields, how are they excelling and what are they doing in their fields, so to learn from them and who are the movers and shakers of the state. Yeah.
Morning everyone, my name is Uchika Mubarakana. Today I really look forward to get introduced to a lot of new people. So that I grow personally as well as professionally. I would like to connect to all the leaders of Madhya Pradesh today and go ahead.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Vishwanath Mukherjee. I represent Hindalco Industries Limited, part of the Aditya Birla Group. And more than the expectations, actually, I wanted to make a comment or a remark. So I happened to work in MP for the last 10 years. So earlier I was in Nagda and I was meeting my current Nagda colleagues. So I was in Nagda for 4 years. From 13 to 17, and now again in MP in Singrauli with Hindalco for the last 6 years. So I think At an MP scale, I have not seen any kind of a Best Employer Brand Awards earlier. I mean, I think this is the first time because I have not seen any kind of MP, an award in MP on this scale. So this was a pleasant surprise also, and I feel it's a good thing that for a state like MP, which has a lot of industries in various pockets of the state, so it's a good get together and a good coming together of professionals, and this is a good opportunity for us all to network and build upon this. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Myself, Dr. Abhishek. I'm from Ultratech Cement, from Aditya Villa Group itself. And I'm happy to meet my colleagues over here. And I think, as he rightly said, that it was the first time that award ceremony is organized in Madhya Pradesh. Because we have been listening state award for Rajasthan or other neighboring states. But I think this is the first time where the leadership award is being given, and I feel privileged to be part of it. Thank you.
All right. Thank you for your kind comments and observations and what you just shared. This is actually not the first time we are doing an MP. It's almost 5 years. It's just that with the pandemic coming in, it got disrupted. The entire lovely journey which was going on in 2019 just got suddenly disrupted for the next 2 years. And even though people are saying that they are out of the wind, they are still not. We still are facing a little bit of aftershocks of that unfortunate havoc that was created by an invisible demon or an enemy, as you may call it. But we still, as humans, persist. That's we all do it. We stand up together. We came together as a globe. We forgot that we are Indian. We forgot we are from US. We forgot we are from London or Africa or the Middle East. Everyone came together and pitched their own way and ensured that we work together as one. Medicines, flights, healthcare stuff, oxygen concentrators, everyone came together to pitch in and act and get this all in place to ensure a smooth survival. And now we are currently on a growth path right now. And when you say about an MP state or something, earlier we used to look at nation integration, but now that we are thinking more local, so we are looking at a more local flavor to come in, because once you strengthen your roots, once you strengthen your foundations, automatically the entire building which comes up is standing on a very small, strong ground, as you may say. So that's what we are trying to do in our own humble way of getting individuals and companies across local states to come together under one common roof and not give it a domain-specific motive rather than a more heterogeneous leadership-oriented track. We all are leaders here. So we all are here to share experience and also share our knowledge, what we have. And most importantly, build our network more stronger, come together, and stand up for United MP in this particular event is what I'm doing here. If the same dialogue would have played in another state, I would have repeated the state name with another one which I was currently in. Kudos to our PM and kudos to the CM here in terms of the vision that they are looking at. And I hope that the next year brings in an equal joy for us. Because what has started off 8 years back as a journey for the youth and for infrastructure that we are looking at as an Indian per se is unprecedented. I'm sure you all agree that these past 8 years has been tremendous in terms of people know that the moment an Indian stands up, they know what this is. So the name is most synonymous with the current PM per se, because when he goes anywhere across the globe, people look up to him as a messiah, as a savior. And he also makes sure that in his own special way of talking, which I've seen, the way he depicts himself is something which creates a lot of energy and makes someone standing in front of him absolutely at ease. So that's diplomacy which he's saying in terms of his, not his actions, but his just body language ensures that he's winning half the battle before the battle starts itself. So that's how he depicts it. We now will play another, it's a two words that we're giving him. This is not just two words of independence that was coming in, Jai Bharat and Vande Bharat. Now we are going to talk about Vande Mataram. This was a mantra that was coined during independence and it still has a lot to do with the current status that we are in. these two words depict what we are, and who best than world leaders to come back and reinforce the same. Some of them are not with us. This is an old AV, but it still holds ground even in today's age. Can we play the AV, please? Something which you like, some should be spontaneously coming out. You don't need to look at left or right, just do it if you feel like applauding. Others will automatically join. So thank you so much, and those who applauded, those who didn't also, thank you for that, because I think you are still soaking it in, absorbing what just happened, what just came on the screen. But let me see if I can get just two people, one from this side and one from this side, to give me a little bit more in terms of what the AV hit you. I just need one volunteer from here.
So for me, the most impactful thing was the message of peace, and as humanity as one world, the concept which we are living into now, Vasudev Kutumbakam. So it's a big family that we are all part of as a humanity, and it's just not between nations. Like Vande Mataram is a two words which depict India as a one world, and Vande Mataram, we pray to our mother land, and similarly all the world leaders, top world leaders, are also praying to their motherlands and our motherland, which is the earth, which is which we all are part of. So this is what it means. It's a bigger family in which we are a smaller unit, in which we are doing our best to for the entire family as a whole.
Sir, as far as I know, Vande Mataram word was coined by Bankim Chandra ji. He mentioned it in his novel Anandman, and that was pre-independence era, whereby he brought a concept of where the whole world, like he said that Vasudev Kutumbakam, his whole world is in a, so we are all connected, and we all belong to the motherland, and we are equal in front of motherland. So our prime minister's aim, like one world, and like we are all for others. So these are the concepts which have been with us since ages, and now we are happy that in the leadership that our country is giving us, and we are all realizing those golden eras of India, whereby we are feeling proud of our country, of our belonging, as well as we are having a secular, or means we are treated as a equal. So that is more essence that I find, and Vande Mataram and AV team has done a good job in bringing all the world leaders who are the Nobel Prize peace winners, and that's great compilation. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much. Those were some wonderful views that just came up. I hope that there are new people who join this discussion as well, the morning progresses, and get some newer thoughts and newer blood into this. Vande Mataram is all is a mantra that is there, definitely is there. Vasudev Kutumbakam is another one. And now India, with heading the G20 presidency, I think you're going to hear it a lot more now coming in. And people are going to talk about it. India as a country is not just about zeros and maths altogether. We have a lot of things to offer to the world, which we ourselves have forgotten also internally as a nation. But now we are feeling proud of calling ourselves Indians, and we are feeling proud that people are looking up to us for solutions, which was hardly the situation before. We came together during the 83 World Cup, the 2007 World Cup, that's national integration for us. We needed sport to bring individuals or the country together, but now we have science, we have technology, we obviously have sports, we have music that brings people together, and most importantly, what we have is a great, rich spiritual heritage that we have. The legacy that we have from the various places of interest that people come and go. Now they call this as a spiritual destination. They say religious tourism. These are all new terms which have come in. And that's helping us as a country to depict and showcase our strengths to the people who are there. may be good, may be bad, may be commercializing a situation also, but we are showcasing our strengths to them. How many of you actually say a prayer at home or at office before you start work in the morning? Are you shy to raise your hands right up? Okay, quite a few of you are there. You say prayers at home first. Let me see how many are there at home. Okay. Now at office? Hands are lesser. People are saying prayers more at home before leaving because you need a safe journey to reach your destination. Office to samali lega. No sit much bed na wahan pe. Lekin wo 9 baje tak pahunchne ke pehle traffic na ho, bheed na ho, sab kuch sahi jaye, to main sahi samay par pahunch jaun. That's more important is what you're doing. Okay, I will show you a short AV. This will be, just make yourself, just relax as much as possible. Just sit relaxed and pay as much attention as you can to the AV as it comes up. Just listen to the music and look at the images. Just two actions that I'm requesting you guys to do. The rest all will fall right in place like a jigsaw puzzle. I promise you that. Can we play the AV please, lights off? I would ask you guys to applaud it. It should come within. If you are soaking it in, let it be. This was a very different thing that we presented to you. And I hope I get some newer people to talk now.
Sir, very good morning. Well, this has been a spiritual Shabbat from Gurbani. And I firmly believe that what we all have been taught from our childhood, that God is one. There is one message of love, peace, prosperity. And all the religions say in a different manner, but at the end of the day, they all teach the teachings of all the religions, of all the saints and all the prophets, everyone remains the same. And we firmly believe that our guru, who is a teacher, who is a mother, who is a father, or our, you know, a saint who we believe, or the religion we believe, so he or she, whatsoever may be, it is the divine power. So we should believe in the power, not you know, go by the religion. And we should all, as a human, spread this message of love, whatever religion we follow. So we should always spread that message of love and, you know, prosperity. And we should live in harmony.
Morning, Alok, and all the esteemed colleagues that are gathered here today. I'm Priyanka. I'm representing Fusion Global Business Solutions today. And I was actually listening to it with my eyes closed because, you know, the vibes, the vibrations, the music itself puts you at peace. You know, that is the feeling I get even now. And, you know, you asked us to soak it in and not, you know, applaud. Probably that is the feeling I get, you know, a bit more of mindfulness and resilience as well. So the strength we have inside. These kind of, you know, AVs put us in touch with our inner core. And that is the kind of connection I still feel, you know, even after the AV has closed. So that is what I wanted to put out, you know, the resilience, the peace, and our strength within ourselves. Sometimes we don't even realize what is inside us. So that was, you know, looking into my own inner self. That is the feeling I received. Thank you so much.
Well, as a host, as someone who hosts a lot of events, I get to travel a lot. Used to living out of suitcases before COVID hit. After that, it's been more grounded due to aging parents. But still, the travel still continues. And we played the same. We used to applaud for this for a few when we played it before. But in my last event, which we did in Chandigarh, an elderly Sikh gentleman got up and he said that you don't applaud for the Gurbani, you just soak it in and you just thank God and move ahead. So that's why I didn't want you guys to applaud. If it comes internally, it's okay, but I don't want someone, because I didn't want to disrespect religion. But I didn't know this part of the Gurbani, that you don't need to applaud once it gets over. So you just need to thank Almighty and take your journey ahead. So for those of you who applauded, thank you so much for doing that, because I'm sure it hit you at some point in some core or some DNA or some chord that is struck with you. And thank you so much for sharing those views as we started off this program this morning. So The energy is still now vibrant. I can feel it. I can sense it. I can see a lot of smiling eyes and faces. The most important thing is no mask, because we recently came from Philippines and there was 60% people were wearing masks still as mandated, but it was not compulsory for everyone, but those who had to use them. But people still wore masks out there. We didn't. So we were actually, when you said the odd man out, you could look at us and anyways we look different from them. So we actually were. Though there are a lot of Indians in the Philippines who speak Pinoy so fluently that you think they are actually Indians, but they are not. They are actually second generation Indians based out of Philippines and staying there. All right, now we would like to thank our two presenters for this entire show, who carried and show this event is possible. One is ADP, who is a strategic partner, and the other one is the Indira Group, which is an academic sponsor for us.